Following EASA certification, the long-awaited first passenger flight on the Airbus A321XLR is fast approaching. For now, at least, it'll be between Madrid and Boston in mid-November, operated by Iberia. The Spanish carrier replaced fellow IAG member Aer Lingus as the XLR launch customer following a pilot pay dispute. So, what do we know about the first two XLR routes? Well, first off, as you'll appreciate, the nature of entry into service of any new type or variant is fraught with complications. While entry into service is subject to change, the details in this video are correct as of August 2nd. So, the first route is Madrid-Boston from November 14th. The route's length is 2,963 nautical miles, or 5,487 kilometers. Iberia has served it since 2007 on the A340, and following that type's retirement, primarily the A330. The XLR will initially serve Boston three times a week alongside a weekly A330 service. In the run-up to Christmas, it'll rise to five weekly and then six, all on the XLR, before becoming daily XLR in late January 2025. The narrow-body variant's winter schedule is shown here, with all times local. Being a bit slower than the A330, the XLR's block time to the US will be 10 minutes longer and 15 minutes longer back. Iberia's A321XLRs are configured with 182 seats, 14 lie-flat business seats, and 168 economy seats. At the time of video production, the second known route is Madrid to Washington Dulles, with a distance of 3,316 nautical miles, or 6,141 kilometers. With a scheduled deployment beginning January 15, 2025, it'll be six times weekly, replacing the A330. For this route, there's a considerable 9-hour and 20-minute block time to the US due to headwinds, a rather long time to be on a narrow body. While an airline might be able to fill an A330 or another wide body, it can definitely fill an XLR year-round. But this comes at a cost. Higher seat mile costs, offset by lower sector costs, but far fewer passengers to break even at a particular percentage point. It also means very little cargo can be carried. Overall, the XLR is a lower risk option than a wide body, especially in winter. Having far fewer seats per flight enables an airline to have higher frequencies than might otherwise be the case in summer. Madrid to Boston will rise to double daily XLR next summer, double the route's previous high. In the less demanded winter, a route's frequency can be reduced, helping with loads, fares, and yields. The aircraft can be redeployed to more profitable endeavors. However, given the lower capacity than a twin aisle, frequencies might still be higher. While Iberia served Boston with 4 to 5 weekly flights with wide bodies in February 2024, it'll be daily service next year. What do you think of Iberia's initial plans for the A321XLR? Let us know by leaving a comment. In addition to our daily YouTube videos, Simple Flying publishes over 150 articles every week. If you're looking for the latest aviation news and insights, visit simpleflying.com.